Good morning, everyone. Lovely to see you all this morning for our family service today as we gather at St. Andrew's. Hopefully you're all able to see an order of service, or someone next to you has one, do feel free to join with them. And where there is bowl type, do feel free to respond during the service. This is the sixth Sunday of Easter. It's also known as Rogation Sunday. Just a couple of announcements to give before I hand you over to Stuart to lead our service. Our online Bible studies continue this week on Wednesday from 11 a.m. And we are continuing to look at the fruits of the Spirit from Galatians chapter 5. And this week it's the turn of kindness. So the fruit of the Spirit, that is kindness. Do feel free to join us if you can on Wednesday, or certainly even after that when you get time. Once it's uploaded, it's always there. Next Sunday, our service of the Word will be here in the church hall at 11 a.m. with special emphasis next week on the work of the BB and the GFS, and particularly here at St. Andrew's. Do indeed feel free to come along to that next Sunday. Also, to let you know, Sunday School have uploaded a wee bit more work for our children online. Again, next Sunday you can tune into that before the service at 11 a.m. For our children. That will run each Sunday as a little course online, running right through to mid-June, when of course the summer hiatus will then come into effect over July and August. So for all our children, there is a bit of work online, but it's leisurely and it's fun. Do feel free to join in on that each Sunday now until mid-June. I think it's the 13th is the last one. Over to Stuart.
Thank you, Reverend Jeffrey. And as we begin the service, we begin as usual with the greeting. The Lord be with you. And as we reflect on our actions this past week, or since we last met in God's presence, let us affirm our trust in God's mercy and confess that we need forgiveness. Lord God, you created the world and made us in your own image. Forgive us when we turn away from you. Lord, have mercy. Lord God, through your Son, you overcame evil and death. Rescue us from slavery to sin. Christ, have mercy. Lord God, by your Spirit, you restore us to fellowship with you and with one another. Breathe your love and freedom into our lives. Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us stand now to begin our praise with the song, My Lighthouse.
Thank you.
seated for our reading now, and Tom will bring our reading to us.
The reading comes from Psalm chapter 98. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvellous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made known his salvation. He has revealed his righteousness in the sight of the nations. He has remembered his steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. All ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing praises. Sing praises to the Lord with the lyre of the sound of the melody, with the trumpets and the sound of the horn. Make a joyful noise for the Lord, King, the Lord. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the world and those who dwell in it. Let the rivers clap with their hands. Let the hills sing for their joy together. Before the Lord, he comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and people with equity. Here ends the reading.
Thank you to Tom for that reading. We now have a chance once again to sing our praises with the familiar and popular children's hymn, Jesus Loves Me. Let us stand to sing.
Please be seated. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we do thank you for this family service, this time together as family, as families of our own from different homes, but as a family under your name, the Church of God. We pray for all of us this morning as families, as individual people. We ask for your blessing upon us now as we look at your word, and we pray that you will speak to us through it. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. This morning I want to ask a question, and I want you to try and guess the answer to it. I'm going to give you a description of something, and I want you to try and tell me what it is. Now, if you've been following our reading, and again, feel free to do it, it's in the order of service, Psalm 98, which Tom read for us. It's not often that we do speak on the Psalms, but today I thought this was a great Psalm of what I really want to say. I'm going to describe something, first of all, before we look a little further at the Scripture itself. This item I'm thinking of is gold in color. it makes a noise. One end of it is larger than the other, and you blow into one end of it, and it has three main keys on it. Does anybody know what that might be? Yes, yes. Are there any people in church this morning belong to a brass band? Or had connections with a brass band locally or further away? No, nobody. Okay. I know there are pipe band folks and accordion band folks in church, okay? Well, I wasn't sure about the brass band, but you got it. It is a trumpet. A trumpet. Now, a trumpet is mentioned a lot during the Bible. It's a very important instrument. It brought the sound of God's voice, we believe, in the Old Testament in different places. It hailed something coming very important. Or when the temple was opened, there was a sound of trumpets everywhere. And if we look at Psalm 98 this morning, it has a lot about music in it. It has a lot about different types of music. Now, I want you to listen very, very carefully, because off to my right, you're going to hear some different sounds. And I want you to try and guess the musical instrument. There are a few of them over here hidden. And I want you to try and guess which instrument it might be. So, Christine, if you go with the first one. What is that? I let the children go first. Guys, do you know what that sound was? Anybody know? Yes. It's a what? Sorry. What was it? Wow. Yes. Yes. Anybody else want to? Now, it's a particular type of one. There are different sizes in this particular instrument. Does anybody know exactly what it is? Very good guess. Yes, it's a recorder, but it's not, you know, the little one you get at school, guys. It's not the little one. I'm going to actually bring this thing out, okay, to let you see it. It is a recorder. So if I could just take it off you, Christine, if that's okay. Sorry, Samuel, thank you. Oh, up there, thank you. That's great. Look at the size of this thing. Have you ever played one that big before? That's a large recorder, isn't it? It takes a lot of blow, doesn't it, to get it going, that big recorder. Now, I don't know, Christine, do you know about, is this a treble recorder or a bass or?
Tenor.
It's a what?
Tenor.
Oh, it's a tenor. It's a tenor recorder. So there you, I'm going to leave that on the table. That, very good, guys. You got that well off there. So that's the recorder. Okay. Now, we don't see it often played outside of school. It's not an instrument you see that very often. So that's the first one. Now listen very carefully again. Here's another sound. What on earth is that? Good man, Jacob. Yes, a mouth organ. Or does anybody know another name for it? Harmonica. Yes, you're very good. You're very in tune, folks. A lot of musical people in church this morning. Christine, maybe grab that off you too, if it's not too much of a stretch there. Great. There we are. Yeah, you might see this one as easy. It's a lot smaller, isn't it? There you are, the harmonica or mouth organ. Very good. Very different sound to the recorder. Now, we have two more. Okay, you're doing good. You're 50% there already. Okay, Christine, number three. It takes a lot of blow with this one.
Not happening.
It's not happening. No?
No.
Okay. Well, we'll bring that one out, will we? Not going at all. Okay. Believe it or not, that's all the size of it. It's a little silver thing. And it's not making the sound. There is a certain way of blowing it. Does anybody know what that is? Good man, well done, well done. It's a kazoo. Anybody ever heard of a kazoo? Who hasn't heard of a kazoo? It makes an awful, I don't know how you'd describe the sound. It's not very musical, put it that way. But people use it. Buskers, you know, have you heard of buskers, the one-man show? He's a drum on the back, and he might have the cymbals on that between his legs, and he might be playing the guitar and all sorts of things. And he might blow this as well. It's got a funny sort of a sound. But that's a kazoo. It is quite hard to blow. There's a little membrane goes into it. But that, it actually might be not working now. That's the problem with it there. So hopefully, the last one is also quite difficult to blow, but Christine, give it a go, if you can. What's that? What on earth is that? I want to see a snake coming out of a basket or something with that. Anybody know what that is?
Chanter.
Yes, yes. Well done. It is indeed. I'll just grab that too, Christine. You can rest now. It's the chanter. I know there's a few pipe band folks in church, okay. That's the chanter. Yes, again, not that easy to blow. But you got the sound off. There's not one of them you didn't know there at all. Now, some of them are quite unusual instruments. You don't see them every day being played. And of course, if you look up on the stage here, we have the piano with Claire here. And you also see Samuel on the drums. And don't forget one of the strongest instruments of all. This in here. Voice. Singing. We've got Alan and Christine doing that today too. And I know our other groups have come up as well. And of course, we have violins and guitars too when they're present on stage. Loads of instruments. In fact, there are literally thousands of instruments in the world. And if you go up to foreign countries sometime, you see instruments that you would never see in this part of the world. And they're all to make music. They're all to make music. But let's get back to Psalm 98 for a couple of moments. I want us to look at the tail end of the psalm first of all. It shows us about and tells us about a God who judges. Do you see that? The presence of the Lord, for he's coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with equity. And it was different translations, slightly different words there. But it tells us about a God who judges. And then the middle bit of the psalm is about the music. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Verse 4. And I remember saying that to someone who claimed he couldn't sing. Make a joyful noise to the Lord. The Lord knows your heart. He said, well, my noise isn't very joyful to other ears. That can happen. Some of us in church today might think we can't sing. And perhaps that is true. But don't let it restrict you from singing. It's the heart that counts. Out of the heart comes praise. Out of the heart comes love for the Lord. And that includes our singing, regardless of what it sounds like. It's the Lord looks at the heart, not what the sound coming out of it is. So do sing. Do sing. Make a joyful noise to the Lord. And then we see, break forth into joyous song. So singing, sing praises. Sing praises to the Lord with the lyre. The lyre is an Old Testament word for the harp. The harp, it was an oval-shaped harp from the Old Testament. The lyre and the sound of melody. Trumpets, sound of the horn. Make a joyful noise before the King, the Lord. And then, this is Rogation Sunday, which is all about the earth. And we plant this time of the year for our crops, for the autumn. And we celebrate that today too. And there's aspects of the earth there. The sea roaring and all that fills it. The world and those who live in it, let the floods clap their hands, let the hills sing together for joy. The very earth is crying out in praise to God. So music, singing, all of that, even nature itself is praising God. But it's a God who's going to judge. And we might say to ourselves, why would I want to praise a God who's going to judge me? Why would I want to give wonderful praise and joy to a God who's going to judge me? Well, the answer is in the first part of the psalm. You see, God has two main characteristics. He's many, but two main ones. One of them is he is a judge. The other one is he's a God of love. And we have to get the balance right. And the God of love comes out in the first part of the psalm. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he's done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have given him the victory. The Lord has made known his victory. He has revealed his vindication in the sight of the nations. He has remembered his love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. And the victory is the cross. This is hundreds of years before it actually happens. But Jesus goes to the cross for you and for me to die, so that we can have victory over sin and death. And we celebrate that at Easter, and we continue to celebrate that in our lives. This is the wonderful thing he has done for us, so that we can have new life and no fear of judgment when it comes that time for all of us. All of us will face the Lord one day, but we have no fear of his judgment when we are in him, serving him, loving him, standing fast in his victory at the cross, because he gives us the cross out of love. And the balance of that with his judgment, that those who don't receive his love, it's offered to us all, but those who don't receive it, unfortunately the Bible tells us that he will judge. So that's why we make noise and praise and music to the Lord. We should have hearts of praise for him every day, not just as we gather in church, but every day in our lives. We should be singing to him from our hearts. And if we play instruments, we praise him with those as well, because he's a God of love and what he's done for us and the victory through the cross. And then to have no fear of his judgment. So we'll leave that with you today, everyone. I hope and pray we know his victory through the cross, his love given to us, and that when that heart is transformed in following him, it should be a heart of praise and love back to the Lord with our music, our song, everything that we do. And to know that we can stand fast in him on the day of judgment. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of music, and we thank you for the gift of instrumentation that many of us do have, but many of us don't have that as well, but yet all of us can sing, even though it mightn't sound that great at times. It's the heart that counts. And the heart can sing when it's standing fast in your victory from the cross, because of new life you give us, that we have the fullness of life, and we should praise you for dying for us, Lord. And may that be lifelong. Even when days are tough and when we don't feel like doing it and we're maybe down, that our hearts can still stand fast in your love, and we can still praise you. And then, Lord, on the day of judgment, we know we can stand fast. Your word tells us that when we are in you, even though we pass through that time, we go into heaven to be with you forever. And Lord, we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you to the Reverend Jeffrey for that lovely message to us this morning. We now have an opportunity to affirm our faith in the words of the Creed, the question and answer version. Let us stand and confess our faith. Do you believe and trust in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe and trust in God the Son? I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated for our time of prayer. we begin with the collect for today, the sixth Sunday of Easter, which is also known as Rogation Sunday. God, our Redeemer, you have delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. Grant that as by his death he has recalled us to life, so by his continual presence in us, he may raise us to eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And thinking of Rogation Days, O gracious Father, we acknowledge that our lives and seasons are in your mighty hands. We thank you for making the earth fruitful, so that it may produce what is needed to sustain our life. Bless those who work in the fields, on the waters, in the industries and commerce in our land. Grant that we may all share the fruits of the earth, and save us from selfish use of what you provide, that together with the poor and needy, we may rejoice in your goodness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And a prayer for our nation at this time. God and Father of us all, graciously bless this our nation, and send your light and your truth to lead us in the paths of justice and peace. Give wisdom to those who exercise authority in the government of our land. Remove all causes of contention and strife among us. Unite us in the service of your kingdom, and make us a God-fearing people, regarding your laws and living together in brotherly love and concord. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And as leaders of the world are soon to meet together, we pray for the peace of the world. Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace proceed, kindle, we pray, in every heart the true love of peace, and guide with your pure and peaceable wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility your kingdom may go forward till the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Heavenly Father, we remember and pray for your church throughout the world, particularly for our mission partners in Italy through Crosslinks, in Arnhem Land through MAF, and in DR Congo through CMSI, particularly for the stressful situation in North Kivu Diocese. We pray for security, for vulnerable people, for the church and Bishop Isasomo, his team, Mama and Bamboo, the staff and the children in the CCD home complex, for their safety, deliverance, and relief. And closer to home, we humbly ask your blessing on all the leaders and children of our youth organizations and all other parish organizations and activities. And we remember all young people who at this time are completing exams and assessments, approaching the end of school term, and preparing to change schools or to go on to further education after a very trying past time. And a prayer for our homes and families. Heavenly Father, we thank you for our homes and families, for our food and clothing, and for all the happiness that parents and children can share. We ask that your love may surround us, your care may protect us, and that we may know your peace at all times. For Jesus' sake, amen. And there are a number of our parishioners at present going through a concerning time of illness. Some people have been very ill, some people have been recovering, some have been in hospital, some are at home. And as we recall those known to us this morning and mention them silently in our hearts, we pray to our Almighty Father to be present with those who are in sorrow, in suffering, in sickness or distress, together with their loved ones. Help them to know your love, that they may seek strength from you and find peace and healing in your presence. And we thank you for those who are recovering and for the skill and care of all health professionals and the support workers. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we've been thinking and speaking of music this morning, been reading about it in our psalm, and we've heard it preached by the Reverend Jeffrey. And we think of the way that we are blessed with music in our church. Creator God, we praise you for the gift of music and song, for the inspiration given to those who compose it, for the skill and devotion of those who choose it, perform and lead it, for the faculties and powers which enable us to join in and enjoy it. We pray that you will sanctify and accept our music in church and make it an offering of praise to the glory of your holy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we conclude our time of prayer with the Lord's Prayer. As Jesus has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And now we come again, a chance to use our voices and our musical instruments this morning again to sing hymn 565 in our hymn books. Father, I place into your hands the things that I can't do.
Let us pray. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us this day and forevermore. Amen. God bless you all. Hope to see you all next week.